Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Q Trends for Thursday, November 10th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning, we've got a nice pop in futures. Dow futures are up over 100 points, so we are looking for some buying at the open on Thursday morning. Well, Wednesday was a painful day in the market. We saw fear spike 33% on the day, and that pushed the NASDAQ down. We still haven't broken down from being sitting up here at the top of the range. We're up at the top of the panic zones. We have been overbought, and so now we're looking for some breakout or breakdown. We can certainly make higher highs from here, but it's looking very unlikely at the moment. We're looking for a breakout of this range. 59.38 on the upside and two lines down brings you down to 56.25. Yesterday we didn't test the lows. We didn't test the 56.25 level. We're still in this little triangle here looking for a breakout or a breakdown. We certainly have a lot of support below us. We have all the major moving averages, the 50, the 100, and 200. Moving average. The pros actually gave up control yesterday with the big sell-off that we saw. Now the futures are up in the pre-market this morning, so when I unwind the bullish trade, I am going to be able to do that at higher prices. So the pain from yesterday isn't going to be as much as it was at yesterday's close. So the TQs are back on a sell signal. The Horizon Beta Pro bear bull product is back on a sell signal, unfortunately. We're still waiting for the SQs to close above 1982. We're now back on a buy signal for the Horizon Beta Pro NASDAQ bear ETF. And so we'll have to take that trade at the open. So with the 33% spike in volatility yesterday, everybody's got to feel a little queasy. If you know, this is your only position and you don't have other things to offset what's going on in the NASDAQ, and that's one of the reasons that we trade multiple pairs of ETFs at the same time. If you're sitting there and this is your only position, then you might want to sit out the next couple of trades until we get some guidance here on what's going on. We're either looking for a breakout of this triangle, either a breakout to the upside or a breakdown, and or we're looking for a breakout of the trading range between 59.38 and 56.25. So all I can say is if you don't have other pairs to offset what's going on in this volatility, you know, sit out the next couple of trades until we get more guidance. Looking at the 60-minute charts, certainly projecting lower prices here. We have another open gap there that could potentially act as resistance on the way back up. We're back below the hourly flypaper channel. And when you get below the flypaper channel, that's where daily sell signals usually show up, which we see on the daily charts. And that's certainly where the bears have taken control on a short-term basis. We found support at the 200-hour moving average on Wednesday. We'll have to see if that holds on Thursday. Next target to the downside is the 56.25 level, and then below that is 55.86. Those are our next two targets on the downside. Obviously, we're going to open higher on Thursday. First sign of strength on Thursday is going to be an hourly close above 57.87. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. I'll be back on Friday. So have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Friday morning.